Tim Pierce here. I'm here with Marty, and I'm going to break down this beautiful kind of A minor 9 thing, and let's do it. So to me, this is one of the most beautiful kind of rhythm parts that I've ever experienced, and it's in A minor, but it's an A minor 9, and the A minor 9 that I'm playing is kind of identical to a C major 7. If you play it with C in the bass, it's a C major 7. If you play with A in the bass, it becomes an A minor 9. And it's kind of easy in a way to visualize because it's really like a stairway. All the fingers are kind of symmetrically just kind of going string to string and one fret at a time. So check it out. Take your little finger on the 10th fret, 4th string, put it down, and then go to the next string and do it on the 9th fret. Go to the next string, do it on the 8th fret, and then on the next string, do it on the 7th fret. Let's do it in reverse. Index finger, first string, 7th fret. Second finger, second string, 8th fret. Third finger, third string, 9th fret. Fourth finger, fourth finger, fourth string, 10th fret. That's the first chord. Second chord is really simple. It's just barred with your index finger across the 5th fret. It creates an A minor chord. You want to have the open A note, and then you want to bar across these four strings. Go back up to the first chord, and then come down, and on the 7th fret, kind of do the same thing, except I don't really want to play that high E note. I think that's not really part of it. It doesn't matter if you do, but I kind of like the way it sounds better if it's just open A, these three notes, strings 2, 3, and 4, barred. Fret 7, and then I like muting that, so check it out. And give yourself some time to work it up, because this might be tough for you to grab if you haven't done it a lot. Do it really slow. One of the things that can help you is the open A is ringing all the time, so you can kind of cheat a little bit. See how it's still ringing? Grab the chord. And then eventually you'll connect them better. So now I'll show you the lead part. And it's kind of A minor pentatonic, and it's just a really kind of dreamy melody. So check it out. You slide up on the 3rd string, pick the note, and slide up to the 9th fret with your 2nd finger. And then on the 8th fret, index finger, 2nd string, hit it twice, hammer on, up 2 frets, up to fret 10. And then we kind of go back down. And this can be done a couple of different ways, but the start of this phrase is... So strike the note and hammer on. Strike it again. And then what I just did was I brought my 3rd finger to the 9th fret on the 3rd string and did a pull off and kind of a seesaw back up to it. You could also, if you wanted to, use your 2nd finger and just slide it. Both sound good. The next part of the phrase starts the same way, but you pull up on the 10th fret and then drop it back down. So what you need to do is you need to pull up before you strike the note. Well, maybe you can strike it. Nah, that's wrong. You can strike it as you pull up. Find a compromise. Drop it back down. Play that note with your next finger on the 8th fret, and then that's kind of a minor 6 thing. So the way that phrase starts is you simply drop your index finger back 1 fret to the 7th fret and play this phrase. And end it on the 9th fret, 3rd string. So I'm going to do that whole series really, really slow. Thank you. honestly, you can change out your fingers as you feel comfortable. There's no rule about which fingers to use. The next piece that happens is kind of a signature little blues turnaround. They go, and that's the third finger, fourth string, seventh fret. And then the index finger, third string, fifth fret. And then we play octaves. And the way the octaves start, I use my little finger and my index finger. That way I'm not stretching. But lots of people like to use the third finger and the index finger. I like to use the little finger. My guitar teacher when I was 12 showed me that, and I've never kind of looked back. When I play octaves, I use the little guy and the index finger. So the way this starts is little finger on the third string, ninth fret, and then index finger on the fifth string, seventh fret, and we play the octaves. Down two frets, and then down here, three frets to the B. And then up one fret. Review that. Here we are. Then this next little piece, little fingers on the fifth fret. You have to watch one of the fingers and use it as your guide, kind of. And so let's use a little finger since it's at the top of the kind of, you know, the top of the thing. This next little piece is fifth fret, third string, little finger. And we go up two frets, back down, and then we play this A octave, which is little finger, fourth string, seventh fret, and then the corresponding index finger, sixth string, fifth fret. And then we hit the kind of Hendrix-y E augmented ninth, E7 plus 9 chord. And that, I'll spell that for you. It's the low open E, and then second finger, fifth string, seventh fret. This major triad-y thing here on the sixth fret, fourth string, and then fill in here on the seventh fret with your third finger, and then fill in here with your little finger on the eighth fret, second string. I'll kind of spell it again really slowly. And this actually lays really nicely with your hand. You're not really stretching, you're not really doing any kind of gymnastics. You just kind of lay the fingers across and you get this really nice, it's the Hendrix chord. So let's just do this octave thing again because I kind of raced through it a little bit. And the thing about octaves is you're doing a shape with your hand that you're keeping. So check it out. It's just, once you get the shape, you can put it anywhere. But you want to keep the shape of these two fingers, you know, and their corresponding string and fret things the same each time. One more time. Moving on, we repeat the melody. Already learned the melody. It happened a few minutes ago. The harmony is simply, and I can do this mostly on one string. Check it out. Fret 10. Just walk down the A minor scale. I'll talk it out. Fret 10. Down a whole step. Down a half step. Down a whole step. Walk up. Finish it out on fret 8, string 2, any finger you want.
There you go.